here in your beloved country, in my beloved country, in the Vatican. Bingo! We did this. I don't think I need to elaborate any longer. This is why I like stories more than I like mathematical equations and graphs. Because we have not, we became very wise in certain things and very foolish in we've actually had models of this. We made a model which went like this. From the time immemorial, economy goes in cycles. It's like your mood. This is a Monday morning, this is a Friday. Oh, one last, and then I will again. Do you know what the similarity between interest rate and alcohol? Money time travels, yeah? If I borrow money, I'm really borrowing it for my future. It may look like I'm getting it from a bank or from you or from my friends, but in fact, I'm just taking this one. This is saving. I'm taking this money, putting it here. This is, if I took money from the future, I invested here, let's say I take 10,000 euros, I can now, only a fool would say, if I take a loan of 10,000 euros, only a fool would say that I'm 10,000 euros richer. Of course, I'm not. When the government does exactly the same process, they take 7% GDP deficit, and in that year, the economy grows by 7%. Are we 7% richer? Is our economy 7% more whatever? No. It's not gross domestic product, it's gross debt product. So, time, money can travel in time, and what makes it able to travel in time is interest rate. But you always have to pay back the energy. You know, it's like in Star Trek, you know, so beam me up, Scotty. Now, alcohol, yeah? On a Friday evening, on an occasional Friday evening, when you feel you have an overdose of energy, you get to sing, you look very sexy, you talk to people that you never have enough to talk to, and what's more important, they talk back to you. On a Friday evening, you believe that this additional energy is thanks to alcohol. No. The only thing alcohol does, it time travels your Saturday morning energy and invests it into a Friday evening. But the sum of the energy of the weekend is constant. So interest rate also time travels energy, and alcohol also time travels energy. But you have to take back. That's why we got a hangover.
Okay, Tomas, stay there. I have another question. So, from what you have set up now, it's like the time of choosing around what we are doing now to generate the future.
Yeah.
And it's, if you are speaking differently, I will join you. Let's imagine that we are driving a car, and I'm having two possibilities. To drive the car looking into the mirror, which is in the past, the old model, or to drive the car, you know, looking exactly in front of me and have all vision. What will be the next model to be followed in order
to? The next model to be followed is to try to understand that the goal of the economist is not to increase GDP growth, but in good years to decrease it. It is like to use a.
Like Stoics.
Yeah, exactly. This is, it all makes sense. You know, thank you. It's all this is like saying that the best car driving is the fastest car driving.
Yeah.
There are certain periods, if you go up the hill, you have to put gas into it. If you're going down the hill, you have to brake, slow down the car, otherwise you crush. This is one way how to deal with the crisis. When we were going down the hill, we did not generate any energy, but we put more. So we need to decrease our demand. By the way, did you also notice that consumption is the solution to every problem? What got us into the crisis, I thought everybody agrees, was overdose of consumption. This was the myth that we all believe. Now, what's the solution to the crisis? More consumption. So we solve the problem by consuming more. And of course, the growth we had here was unnatural, it was debt-ridden. You can never have the same amount of growth anymore because we've exhausted that. Our debt level cannot rise any longer. So One important message from this is to be more balanced, have more balanced budgets, and have more balanced psychological ups and downs. In other words, apply stabilizers. And here I am an optimist. We need to treat the manias first. We need to treat the good periods of energy and time first. This, I think, is one short lesson from the ground. And this also, by the way, goes with ethics. You want more than you have a right to. This is the problem with the apple, the problem with the fruit. You want it more than you have the right to. This is the problem with everything. I want a car, I don't have a right to, so I shortcut. I take a shortcut. Yeah.
Did you just visit
the
in Czech Republic?
No.
No, not yet. Everything I like, you know that it's ruled by the number three. And let's say, for example, in the Christian religion, because in our other religions, it's God, it's Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. Yeah, so we agree that the number three is so important. And all the time, it's about the triangle in our life. Okay, let's say that the other day, I'm having the business ethics. What are the other two sides of the triangle that might help me as a business to triangle this crisis and to build successfully out of it?
We are both post-communist countries, and I also believe in the number three. And I think there's three basic guardians of a functioning economy or norms. One is inside, what you call business ethics. I feel when I produce shoes, I don't want to make bad shoes. I just want to make nice, good shoes that people will not only pay for, but will enjoy it. I want people to, of course, buy my book, but more than that, I want to enjoy it. So there's a double pleasure that you want when you sell your products. You don't just want the money, you actually want people to say, I enjoy that. Forget the money part, I enjoy it. So let's just call that internal ethics. So this is one force that drives you to behave properly, not to cheat. The other force, a very strong force, that drives you to behave properly is competition. If I produce bad shoes, sooner or later I will be thrown out of the market. Of course, here I must remind you of this problem. If the whole market becomes sour, then the good business people leave first. But in a standard situation, it's competition that forces you not to cheat. And the third one, like it or not, is regulation. It's regulation. If I sell meat, I have to have fresh meat. I cannot store it in the sunshine. I have regulation. If I sell products for children, we don't want to rely on these two. We don't want to rely on competition if the toys are poisoned or something, or if I am a decent enough business person. We regulate that market very strongly when it comes to healthcare, for example, when it comes to child products, when it comes to fresh meat, etc. So these are three guardian angels for the economy to work, forces that force us to do good. Now, in the case of Czech Republic and also your country, in the beginning of, in the 1989, we didn't have competition. This was the whole thing about capitalism. There was no competition, so we couldn't rely on this one. Regulation, we had 40 years of over-regulation. Nobody wanted to hear about regulation. So the only thing that we could rely on here was some sort of internal norms. But again, after 40 years on the desert of surviving by cheating, this is the difference between communism and capitalism. Communism survived because of cheating. If we didn't cheat during communism, the system would collapse 5 years after it was born. This is how dangerous corruption is. Corruption allowed communism to survive. The richest land would not survive without corruption. But in capitalism, corruption kills it. You know, when you open a file, the file is corrupted. It means you can't use the file, there's something wrong. In the Czech Republic, when I say the deal is corrupted, it means, oh, it will go fine. Or, you know, we bribe it and it will go just like a jelly. So this is why I think there's so much attention put in here, because this is the only leg that we could stand on. And by no means would I argue that our region is less ethical than other regions. Simply for this, we were at a disadvantage. We couldn't count on the two bargaining angles. Look at America, Enron crisis, or look at even the recent crisis in the banking, which you rightly pointed. They had all this sort of in place, and yet the immoral part happened in America. So anyway, this is my answer to the three guardian angels and we are building this, we are building this, and we are building this.
So once again, there are the regulations that we have to study. And you may really want to have regulation, competition, and?
Internal ethics.
Internal ethics, okay, so, this, so it's about competition here, yeah, and regulation here.
Yeah.
Thank you, Tom.